YouTube, DoFanatic95. It's time for Clear Lake's broadcast analysis. This time, number 12? I think it's right. Anyway, so this one I'm not so enthusiastic about, and you probably know why, but in case you don't, I'll just go into it a little bit. So, this one, I'm recording this video right now, Saturday evening. Video came out about 24 hours ago, give or take, and I watched it. I didn't think it was particularly bad, but once I got finished watching it, I don't even remember if I did a repeat viewing immediately. Of course, I did before filming this, but right afterward, I was like, okay. It didn't hit any big themes or anything to build the tension to a great degree that I was like, ooh, I need to go back and watch this again immediately and get my recording done. I was like, you know, I'm really tired. It's pretty late at night, at least by the time I was watching it. And I just went off. I started messing with a new headset I got, and I played some Halo 5, you know, just trying to enjoy myself. And I really didn't think about it much until today, after I'd gotten some rest. And honestly, I think I needed that time, because normally I think my reviews are pretty positive, and I've just been feeling some negativity about this one in particular. But before I get too far into that, I will do a quick recap, of course. This one begins with Are You Awake?, which we've seen before on the Marble Hornets website. Then it fades in to the Bird Watcher as he's sitting in his chair after seeing the Walker go into his closet and not emerge. So that happens. He is awoken by the sound of the emergency broadcast alert system, which we've heard before in a previous broadcast. And he goes over to check his TV, which of course is producing the sound, and it's a staticky screen. He reaches out towards the screen, trippiness ensues, he's on the floor, and then Walker appears over him and looks down upon him before we cut out to complete static. Now, I said I wasn't particularly enthusiastic about this one, and that is because not much really happened. We did get the Are You Awake?, which maybe from whoever the showrunner is, maybe the To the Ark or whoever that is, don't really know, can't speculate. But that does happen, and honestly, other than that, and the fact that we have a cliffhanger till next time, that's really all we got to move this along. Nothing happened. I don't know any more about the series, Clear Lakes 44, I don't know anything more about the plot, I mean, excluding a few minor details, than I did the previous month, or even the month before that, even though the last video was pretty groundbreaking for the series. Now, I don't think that's overly critical, because we are about 5 months into the series, I believe, and still no major plot developments. If you were to ask me, point blank, what is Clear Lakes 44 about? I'd think about it for a second, and I would tell you that I don't know. I really don't know what this series is about, and that's a problem, because I'm losing my interest in this series as they carry on with these short videos that move the plot along, but just barely. Just enough to tide you by until they can get the next video, which will do the same thing. And then, if you really wanted me to attempt to give you an explanation of what the series is about, I would say, so there are these paranormal activities happening, and there are cameras everywhere that inexplicably switch angles to focus on a particular person, whether it be the Bird Watcher, a bearded man with limited mobility, and the Walker, a man in a hoodie with his face basically censored by static the whole time. And they have run-ins every now and then, and the bird watcher seems to have some issues going on with all these paranormal entities that surround him. And all of this might just be tied to another internet series called Marvel Hornets, which, you know, it may have some ties, may not. And that's honestly a general overview of the big plot details we know about this series. And we all watch this because we're the established audience for Marvel Hornets, I'm assuming for most of you. If you're even watching this video, I don't know why you would be otherwise. But we really just don't have a plot, in my opinion. Those small details do not make up a plot of a strong story. Now, you can blame anything you want on the situation. The split between members of THAC, Troy getting and his family getting sick, what have you. You can say all of these things are reasons why this has been moving on at a slow pace. But they're illegitimate excuses, because I don't judge works of fiction based upon the circumstances of the writer. I judge them based upon what they are, and in this case, it isn't much. Now, I know I'm being overly negative right now, but my other videos, I've been trying to keep the positive mindset, and honestly, I think too much optimism can be a bad thing, so I felt it was the right time to bring out the critique. And honestly, it needs it, and the members of THAC need to hear this, not only from me, but from you, the audience, if you are as displeased with the current state of affairs as I am. People on Patreon who support them, I don't personally, because I don't have the funds to do that. But even if I did, at this point, I would not be supporting them, because I don't feel like the quality of their content that they're producing is warranted of such a subscription. So, this is my challenge to members of THAC. Take this criticism and prove me wrong. I want to be wrong about all these things. I want to see that this plot is going somewhere. And I want to see that you can do something that offers originality from Marvel Hornets while at the same time giving us those elements we love. Do that, absolutely. But give us something more to think about from month to month as you produce these videos. Don't give me this one wasn't even 2 minutes, was it? A video like that where I don't have anything to speculate on. Give me something to speculate on. And I know every video can't be that, but you gotta give me something. Something. Throw me a bone, please. I'm not gonna stop watching this series because, honestly, it doesn't take up that much of my time to do this and to do these videos and speculate with all you wonderful people. It's not that hard. So, I mean, of course I'm going to keep an eye on this as time goes by, but my enthusiasm right now about Clear Lakes 44 is plummeting. And I don't want that to happen, but it is. So right now, that is basically what I think of all this. And, you know, I know I've been talking more about the state of the whole series than this video specifically this time around. So just to briefly mention those things, I mean, I don't even honestly know all that you could say about it, but I still don't know the motivations of Walker, and I know I'm clearly not supposed to know them, but why is he here? I really don't know. Why was the emergency broadcast alert playing? Don't know. Honestly, in past videos, I would sit here and speculate about that for, I don't know, 10 minutes or so. But I'm just not feeling it today. And I apologize to any members of my audience who don't like this negativity. But let's face it, I have been overly optimistic in the past. And right now, I have to draw it down a little bit and make it real. So, before this gets out of hand And any more tangents, let's end it here. If you have any comments or questions, anything in the nature to discuss, please put it in the comments. If you believe that they're slipping, especially with the progression of this story, let me know. And ultimately, what can they do to subside this? Should they have longer videos? Should broadcasts be put back to back? I mean, I don't think they would take that long to make, especially if they're not going to be, you know, but like 2 minutes. I know that there has to be some production that goes into that. But maybe if they put, you know, a couple of broadcasts back to back, you know, release one in a week and then one the next week or 2 weeks later, something like that. Maybe that would help the pace out. But something clearly has to be done, and I'm glad I got this off my chest, because honestly, it's been bothering me. I've been thinking about it all day. So that's all I have for the moment to say on the matter. So like this video up if you agree, and subscribe, of course, because, you know, even though I'm down on it right now, let's face it, when Broadcast 13 comes out, there'll be a video, and you'll want to see this. So, hit that subscribe button, and until then, have a wonderful month of waiting, I guess. See you next time.